Welcome back to Dr. O Solutions. My name is Oleg Nikishin. I am a doctor of naturopathy, master of science, and a board certified drugless practitioner. And today we will cover gum disease, gingivitis and periodontitis, and how to treat it with ozone. We receive many, many calls, actually almost every day. People called us, and this is question about the gum disease raises almost every day. Do you know that according to the CDC, half of American adults have periodontal diseases? And as you have it, obviously it will concern you. And you will probably know, or your dentist will explain you, that you have periodontal disease due to microbes or infection in your mouth. In the previous lectures, we covered that how disinfect with ozone. I would like you to go and watch it. We covered it that ozone is approved by FDA for disinfections. Ozone is actually the most potent disinfectant substance known to man. Ozone doesn't leave a residue after it treats the infection. So it simply goes back to state of oxygen. And in the same lecture, I covered how ozone is most potent and it kills bacteria, even parasites. Bacteria and viruses kills within a second, and parasites kills within a minute. And obviously you will say, well, if it works so well for disinfection, why can't we use it for periodontal diseases? And the answer is very simple. Yes, we can use ozone for disinfecting. And since the gum disease and periodontal disease associated with infection in your mouth and the gums and the teeth, then yes, obviously ozone can be used for their treatment. And not only can be used, it is very, very efficient treatment. That's why holistic doctors using ozone for even surgery. So they do disinfecting root canals. Some dentists are using ozone for your teeth cleaning. So that's why we're gonna in this lecture, I will explain you how we can do it very simply at home. There are a few ways to do that. I will start from a very simple one. Now, for instance, if you do not have ozone package at home, if you do not have ozone equipment at home, oxygen, so what you can do, you can start treatment from for your periodontal problems, issues with the our full line of ozonated oils. Ozonated oil, very effective disinfecting substance as well. First, we will cover the Biozole Pure. It's a pure ozonated oil. It's a pure, as we do that in the based on a virgin olive oil. And this is, when we open it, it's in the room temperature, it looked like a jelly. So what you simply do, you can get a cotton swab, or you can use your fingers and rub it right against your gums. It's very well for even toothaches. If you apply ozone oil on the tooth, right on the top, around the gum, and under the chin, that will reduce the pain almost immediately, within a minute. Obviously would not solve that problem, you still have to go and see the dentist, but it will relieve you from that pain. So it works very well. Now, we do have Biozole pure ozonated oil with the zinc, and the zinc is very potent substance, that very potent ingredient that stops viral replication. So if you do have herpes in your mouth, or if your periodontal disease associated not only with bacteria but with the viruses as well, you can rub this oil Also, the oil is so potent. Do not overdo that, because it will can strip your mucosal lining if you do it a lot. Mucosal lining will appear back within a half a day, maybe in a day, but it just don't overdo that, because it works so well. You probably will be very excited. Oh man, it's just simply rubbing it off, and it takes the pain away. So if you do have a pain, obviously you have to deal with it, but later just give yourself a break and let that mucosal lining appear back again. Now, if you do have many periodontal issues, if you do have root canals, that means that you do have inflammation or subsided inflammation in down to your bones. Because root canals most of the time do have internal issues as inflammation. Or if your dentist didn't clear that root canal properly, you go to your dentist and he said, well, you have a root canal, you have inflammation. So if that's the case, that means you have infection in the bone, and that means you're going to have lymphatic stagnation in the upper part of your cheeks. It's right, all goes all the way up, and sometimes you can touch it and you can feel that heat, or you can touch it yourself like that if you touch it down below on the neck, and then you just slide your fingers up and you feel the heat. That means you have inflammation in your gums or even in the teeth. And not only that, you're going to have lymphatic stagnation through the lymphatic ducts, which is located right there in the side of the neck. For that reason, so sulfur activates lymphatic system. That's why we make another biozole plus with the organic sulfur. What you do, this is extremely important ozonated oil. What you do, you just simply rub it right there where you have lymphatic nodes and lymphatic ducts. That will help you for lymphatic drainage. That's one way of treating it. It's not most effective. I will say it's like a maintenance mode. It's on the maintenance side of it. Like if you still have this issue, you need to go down deeper in the gums and clean it. So you go to the dentist. Dentist will do the tooth cleaning and will take that stuff inside the gum and flame that pluck you inside the gum out. But your gums are still bleeding. And they will tell you, so your gums is always bleeding, what can you do? Then, I don't know, I'll try to do this and this and that. So what I use it myself. I use ozonated water to flush my gums. And it stopped bleeding within one day. That's that fast. So for that reason, what you will need to do, you will need ozonate the water. I show you right now how we do it on our flask. You pour that ozonated water in your toothpick, that is water pick, and then will be ozonated water, and you do simply, just like you usually, like you do it all the time with it, you simply go down under your gums and clean your gums with ozonated water. It's very, very effective. You can do it at home. Again, so you go to the dentist, you clean your teeth, so you do the cleaning, and then you come back. Then you do it, I do it twice a day, in the morning and before I go to bed. And let me show you how to do that with the water. So again, we'll put a half a liter in our flask. We start ozone generator. We put I like to put it on 1/8 liter per minute, so the water will start ozonating. So what you will need to do is to ozonate that water, so the water can reach disinfecting level. As I cover in our other video, that there are two levels of concentration ozone in the water. One, it's when ozonated water reaches the level of 2 ppm concentration ozone in the water. That's for basic disinfection. So, or if the water can reach 5 ppm and above, and this is for surgical disinfection. That what probably what you will need if you have severe gum bleeding. So I know it would, since we measure it, so the flask, the ozonated ozonated water in the flask will reach 5 ppm if we will put the settings, for instance, 1/8 or 1/16, and it is a room temperature, as right now it's about 24 degrees, that water will reach between 2 to 5 ppm. Again, that depends on the water. I recommend using distilled water about 20 to 25 minutes. And how you test it? We sell ozonated water test kits. You simply just pour this in a vial, you put a few drops, and as the water goes, the testing solution will go blue. That means you calculate accordingly how much ppms you have in ozone in the water. Now, in order to reach 5 ppm, as one drop represents 0.5 ppm, so you will need 11 drops. Again, this will be covered in another video. I just want to tell you that this is options available for you. Once you calculate it, in other words, if you know now 24 degrees, we put half a liter, we ozonate it for 25 minutes, and we took the measure. And we use the same water, not filtered, for instance, or your filter, but at the same bottle, or the same manufacturer. Or I like to use distilled water. And we test it with this solution, and we time it. So we tested, for instance, 11 drops, 5 ppm, 25 minutes. That means you don't need to test it every time. So your concentration, ozone concentration in the water will reach every time when temperature 24, use the same water, and it's 25 minutes. So you don't have to test it every time, but for your own purposes, I recommend you using that. After our ozonation, water ozonating is done, so what we'll do, we'll just shut it off. And just remember, disconnect, just like it says right there, disconnect your equipment from the top of your ozone generator all the time after each use. You just pour that water in a water pick. Oops. So let the water sit for a few minutes, that the ozone, the free ozone will dissipate from the top. And then you start it on and just use it as a regular water pick. But it will be very efficient on your gum disinfection. So that's all for this video, folks. I think this is a simple way, and I would like to know how you use it. Give us your feedback, share this video, give us your thumbs up, and make sure you join our Medical Ozone Research Group on the Facebook, and share your experience with our fellow members of that group. See you in the next video.